So, good afternoon, friends. We have tried up to problem number 4. Now, we are taking up on to problem number 5. So, it is on capital gains for the assessment year 13-14. Question number 5. Mr. Selvan acquired a residential house in Jan 2000 for 10 lakhs and made some improvements by way of additional construction to the house, incurring expenditure of rupees 2 lakhs in October 2004. He sold the house property in October 12 for 75 lakhs. The value of property was adopted as 80 lakhs with the state stamp valuation authority for registration purposes. He acquired a residential house in January 12 for rupees 25 lakhs. He deposited 20 lakhs in capital gains bonds issued by NHAI in June 13. Compute the capital gain chargeable to tax for the assessment year 13-14. This is the first section of the question. Second section, what would be the tax consequence and in which assessment year it would be taxable if the house property acquired in January 2012 is sold for rupees 40 lakhs in March 2014? Cost of inflation 99,389, 45, 480, 1213, 852. Okay. Now, certain important things that we should basically take up. I have been telling you that capital gains equation is just like any other profit equation. Sales minus cost is equal to profit. Here, sales minus cost equal to gain. See, firstly, let us ensure that the item that we have taken up for discussion is basically a capital asset. Then number two, check up whether it is long-term capital asset or short-term capital asset. Then we take up what is the sale value. Then we will take up what is the cost. We will find out the gain. Then we will take up the exemption provision based on the investment that he is making, and that is the way we have to conclude. The problem also centering around finding out income, not liability. The earlier problem that we have seen, not only the income that we have taken up, even the liability computation also we have taken up. Now, let us just start the discussion this way. Residential house acquired in January 2000 for rupees 10 lakhs. Is it capital asset or not? That is the main area of discussion now. Is it a capital asset or not? Yes, it is a capital asset. Capital asset in which section it is defined? Section 2, subsection 14. See, whether this definition is at the earlier part or at the later part. Income tax department is a department for the Finance Act. Or the Income Tax Act, I mean, Income Tax Act definition comes in the same order as you find in dictionary. So, if you just look into the section reference A, B, C, D, that is the way they have just given. Capital asset is at the C stands at the very early stage. So, therefore, it is coming in section 2, subsection 14. If you have observed it, you just confirm it, whatever I am just saying. If you have not done that, you go through that and enjoy as how they have just given this definition for individual items. So, already when they have defined like 2, subsection 1, 2, 3 and all that, if a new word is to be defined, they will insert 19AA, something like that they will be inserting, but the chronology will be as per the dictionary. So, please just understand, this is an incidental information. So, Section 2, subsection 14, under the definition, it is a capital asset, number 1. Now, having admitted this as capital asset, whether it is long-term capital asset or short-term capital asset. For that, firstly, we should inquire as whether it is financial asset or non-financial asset. Residential house is not a financial asset, non-financial asset. Then, we have to check up whether it was held for a period greater than 36 months. So, the sale is happening by October 12. Whereas the purchases was made by January 2000. So, it is closely 12 years and few months. So, therefore, it is long term capital asset, and therefore the gain that we would be computing would be long term capital gain. Okay, this is the first inquiry that we are making. Then first stage over. Now the second stage that we have got to take up is sale value. Check up from the problem as what is the sale value or net consideration. He sold it in October 12 for rupees 75 lakhs. The value of the property adopted as 80 lakhs with the stamp valuation authority for registration purposes. So at least a few problems you have already done. Then stamp duty authorities have given higher value. That is the value that we provide. We will assume that the assessee is not protesting and it is not referred to any valuation officer. So therefore, we are very clear about what could be the sale value. What could be the sale value? Deemed consideration is what we will be using. Deemed consideration is 80 lakhs. Okay. Now, what is the type of asset? We have already discussed. Then, what is the consideration that we have discussed? What was the reference to the section reference that we have made for this? Section 50C1. So, where they have just defined about that. The next one. The third portion that you have got to take up is acquisition, cost of acquisition and indexed cost of acquisition. So, there was no addition that they have made except for 2 lakhs of rupees that he had made in the year 2004. So, initial purchase of 10 lakhs for which the corresponding index what we have got to use would be 389 and the 2 lakhs additional expenditure that he had made for which they have given you the index. Okay. So, indexed cost of acquisition will be a very simple work that you have got to carry out. Right. Now, what type of asset we have just taken up? Sale value we have taken up. Indexed cost of acquisition also we have taken up. Now, it is the stage that we have got to go in for computation of capital gain. So, sale value minus indexed cost of acquisition and extension will give you capital gain. It is only arithmetical work. Then what is the next stage in our work? We have to check up as how this assessee had planned himself to come out from the tax bracket. So, he had just said he had acquired a residential house in January 2012 for rupees 25 lakhs. So, this portion is covered under section 54. Exemption covered under section 54. So, what is it we are expected to do? So, complaints regarding the timing of purchases. So, he should have purchased 1 year before this transfer, or he should have constructed for a period from the date of transfer within 3 years period, or he should have bought within a period of 2 years. This is what they have just given in 54. Now, in order to just check up the relevant provision, so I would like you people to just visit that. So, now let us just refer to profit on sale of property used for residence. So, in this problem, he have mentioned clearly that it is residential house and he had bought another residential house. So, now let us just take up the relevant paragraph or section there. Subject to subsection 2, wherein the case of an assessee being an individual or an HEF, the capital gain arises from the transfer of long-term capital asset being building or land appertaining thereto and being a residential house. Income which is chargeable under the head income from house property, hereinafter referred to as original asset, and the assessee as within a period of 1 year before, correct, or 2 years after the date on which the transfer took place, purchased, correct, or within a period of 3 years after the date constructed a residential house within bracket clause, instead of the capital gain being charged to income tax as income of the previous year in which the transfer took place, it shall be dealt with in accordance with the provisions of this section, that is to say, we will just refer to this particular thing later. Now, I wanted to take this opportunity to explain the point that we have. What is that point? So, you know that the year in which or the time at which the sale was affected is October 12. October 12 by which sale had happened. So, 1 year before or 2 years after purchases, he should have made this purchases. People might wonder sir, how is that the person can effect the purchases of a new property when the original property itself were not transferred? Correct? Where is that he will have money to buy an asset 1 year before the transfer? See, at this moment, let me tell you the practical scenario. October 12 is the date on which, or the month in which transfer took place. It is not that that particular day only they have identified the buyer to receive the consideration. Consideration of rupees 75 lakhs. I think it is 75 lakhs, no? 75 lakhs, they wouldn't have got it on the day of transfer. So, the willingness to buy the property, they would have identified much earlier and they would have brought about an agreement for sale. That point of time, some token money also they would have provided, or substantial money also they would have provided, but they would be waiting for some other formalities to get over. Correct? So, therefore, the vendor, in this case the assessee, Mr. Selvan, would be having some amount of money, and he never wanted to waste that money or keep it in the bank account. What is it you would have done? He would have purchased the property by that point of time. That is the reason as why you have this provision. So, by taking into account the practicalities, we have this 1 year before and 2 years after for purchase only, whereas for construction purposes, it should be taken up as 3 years. Correct? In this case, this gentleman, Mr. Selvan, had purchased the property by Jan 12 itself. So, January 12 itself is within 1 year period. Therefore, he will qualify for exemption under section 54. Are you understanding, all of you? So, now, you understand that he had just bought it by January 12, 25 lakhs. Now, let us just know about this section. Now, if you are having some numbers, some case study, and then when you are looking into the provision, provision will just go into your mind firmly. There is no way that you will forget. I can as well tell this provision even without any reference to this section. By seeing this, possibly some of you might have that greater amount of confidence. It is not that sir is telling something. So, you just look into the screen where you have income tax department which is giving you all these provisions. So, we are referring to that particular section. So, now let us just proceed to that. If the amount of capital gain is greater than the cost of the residential house, yes, in this case it had happened. What is your capital gain? Capital gain, we are not yet computed, but definitely you can say that 75 lakhs is the sale consideration and 80 lakhs deemed consideration. With that cost of indexed cost of acquisition and extension when you take up, so the amount of capital gain is likely to be substantial. How much we do not know, we will compute that. Now, let us just read the provision completely. So, purchased or constructed herein after in this section referred to as a new asset, the difference between the capital gain and the cost of the new asset shall be charged under section 45 as income of the previous year. And for the purpose of computing in respect of the new asset, any capital gain arising from its transfer within a period of 3 years of its purchase or construction, as the case may be, the cost shall be nil. Why I am just asking you to read this particular section is that you have a second part of the question. What is the second part of the question that they have asked? What would be the tax consequence and in which year, which assessment year it would be taxable? If the house property acquired in January 12 is sold for rupees 40 lakhs in March 14, please understand that from the date of purchase January 12 to the date of sale March 14, how many years? 2 years and 2 months. So, within 3 years period, you are not expected to sell it off to avail this exemption under section 54. In this case, what is that? In the second case, they are telling they are effecting a sale within a period of 3 years. That is, within 2 years and 2 months, they have effected a sale. Therefore, this transfer will be taken up as short-term capital asset, and the gain arising out of that will be taken up as short-term capital gain. Are you clear, all of you? This is conveyed in section 54, subsection A, 1A. Are you clear? So, therefore, the reading gives you better clarity. Let me read out that. If the amount of capital gain is greater than the cost of the residential house so purchased or constructed herein and after referred to as new asset, the difference between the capital gain, if the capital gain is 100 and the cost of the new asset is 40, then what they are saying is that 60 will be taken for taxation as per section 45, charging section. They are saying 60 will be taken up as capital gain, and moreover, on this 40, what they are telling, it should not be sold within a period of 3 years from the date of purchase of this new asset. Are you understanding? That is the second part of the question there. Are you understanding, all of you? Yeah, yeah, yeah. See, any section, you just see, if it were to be, see, the same matter only. Look into that. Look into that, Ganapati. If the amount of capital gain, look into that, the cost of the residential house, so purchased or constructed, is what they have mentioned. And what is that they have mentioned? For the purpose of computing in respect of new asset, any capital gains arising from its transfer within a period of 3 years of its purchases or construction, as the case may be, the cost shall be taken up as nil. Are you understanding, all of you? Are you clear? The next one. Just say, in the diagram, I can just put it like this way. Say, from this date onwards, 3 years period within which, when any transfer is made, within 3 years period, closely follow, within 3 years period, that is what they have mentioned. I am sorry. 3 years period. Within a period of 3 years. Say, there, when they are referring, 36 months is what they are referring. Both are synonymous, okay. Are you clear? Ganapati, are you clear about this one? So, when any transfer is made, then it becomes short-term capital asset, and where you have sale value less cost, cost will be taken up as nil. That is the point that they are telling. Are you understanding? Cost will be taken up as nil. No indexation is permitted for short-term capital asset. Are you clear? Now, we will consolidate. So, we are just traveling here and there, and one more provision also we have got to discuss in this particular case. What is that they have just indicated? And he deposited 20 lakhs in capital gains bonds issued by NHAI in June 2013. What is that? This is to be taken up in section 54EC. So, is it possible for the assessee to claim simultaneously the exemption under section 54 as well as in 54EC? Answer to that question is yes. It is possible that the assessee can claim exemption both under section 54 for the cost of purchase of new property as well as the investment that he is making as per section 54EC. He can do that. Because the property that he is seeing may be lower value, and what would happen for the remaining amount, he is prepared to make investment. So, simultaneous or concurrent exemption is possible through section 54 as well as 54EC. But only one thing is that it should have been done within a period of 6 months from the date of transfer of the original asset. What is the date on which he had effected this transfer? October 12. What is the date on which he had made this investment? June 2013. From January 13 to June 13 itself, 6 months. So, what had happened? The date of transfer being October 2012. So, from the date of transfer to the date of investment, it exceeded 6 months. Therefore, despite making investment in NHAI, he cannot claim any exemption. So therefore, you should have the courage to write this provision. So just because an item is given, possibly weak-minded people might deduct even this amount and they would say, okay, we can deduct anyway you are invested. So the department is giving you lot of time. 6 months time is too much of a time, I would say. So from the date of transfer, and therefore you can go for bringing out this capital gain computation. Shall we consolidate now? So what are the points that we have got to take up? No, I will just put it through Excel, so that everybody can just make note clearly. My handwriting is not that great. What is the matter? First point, residential property, residential house bought in Jan 2000 is a capital asset. Further, what is the name they have used? Further capital expenditure was incurred in the year 2004-05. The entire unit is long-term capital asset. Gain arising out of LTCA is long-term capital gain. Item number 5. Deemed sale consideration shall be rupees 80 lakhs, which is greater than 75 lakhs offered by the assessee. Correct? If you want that section reference, you can do that. 50C within brackets 1. Right. So, our friend had asked a question, nice question. If the expenditure incurred is not 36 months old, there is component basis, I could say. What is that? The entire unit is LTCA is what I have referred. That means, in an asset, there is a chance that one portion may be long-term capital asset, one portion may be short-term capital asset. Short-term capital asset will not qualify for indexation. So, the very rating is that to confirm the point that both the units will be taken up for indexation. So, there is a chance that I may incur some expenditure within a period of 36 months from the date of transfer. Whether it is a capital, long-term capital asset or short-term capital asset is what people would be having a doubt. I think Ganapathy has got that is the point. Am I right? So, let me tell you, in one residential unit, there can be a portion which is long-term capital asset. There can be a portion which can be short-term capital asset. Therefore, only for the long-term capital asset portion alone, you have indexation benefit. For the layer, the latest addition that you have made within a period of 36 months, even 36 months also will be taken under STECA only. More than 36 months only will come under long-term capital asset. So, for the short-term capital asset portion, you don't have indexation benefit. So, therefore, the total sale consideration in which you have these two layers. Are you understanding? Shall we proceed? So, deemed sale consideration shall be 80 lakhs, which is greater than 75 lakhs, offered by the assessee. Right. Now, both the layers will qualify for indexation. Items, cost, financial year, cost, indexed cost of acquisition or extension. Is that clear? So, there should be some way through which you have to take up original asset. Financial year 99-2000, cost 10 lakhs. What is the corresponding index? 480. Index to cost equal to 10 lakhs, I'm sorry, 10 lakhs into 852 divided by 480. Additional thing is that has happened in which year? 4, 5. How much is the amount? 2 lakhs only. That point of time the index is 480. Originally it was 389. Excuse me, sorry, I have just picked up a wrong answer, the wrong index. Kindly make that correction. Nobody is just responding. You simply copy. Right. So now let us just show the computation. A real computation we can just show. Into 852 divided by index. Computation of capital gains. What is that? Deemed consideration. How much is that? 80 lakhs less indexed cost of acquisition, long term capital gain. ₹54,769 less exemption under section 54. How much is the value of the property that they have bought for which they are seeking this exemption? 25 lakhs only. So, taxable long term capital gain is 29,54,769. So, here we have got to put a note. What is the sort of note that we have got to put in? Investment in NHAI should have been made within 6 months from the date of transfer. So, date of transfer being which month? October 12. October 12. So, you just think for in favor of Asachi, end of October, let us take it up. So, let us take it up end of October, November, December, January, February, March, April, correct? April end, you should have invested. So, assuming the transfer took place. See, actually month means they take only, even at the beginning also they will ignore. Month means next month they will count. They will not go by dates. So, we don't have to even just make note of that. So, what we need to do is that we need to tell investment should have been made on or before April 13, correct? 6 months counting will get over by end of April. Are you understanding? See here 4 months, there 2 months, November, December. Whereas investment was made by June 13. Therefore, Mr. Selvan is not eligible to claim exemption under section 54 EC, specified asset. Hence, taxable long term capital gain is 29,54,769. This is the answer for the first part of the question. Are you clear? So, for me to explain all these, to show all the section, it is taking time. Under examination condition, this problem is to be handled in 10 minutes time or answer. I mean, in a very cool way, when you just take up, taking time to think and going back and forth, is not going to take more than 10 minutes. So, the first part of the question. So, second part of the question we need to answer. What is that? What would be the tax consequence and in which assessment year it should be taxable if the property acquired in Jan 12 is sold for 40 lakhs in March 2014? Two questions that they asked. Tax consequence in which assessment year this matter will be taken up. So, people might think that we have to reopen this assessment and it is to be taxed during this assessment year 13-14. No, that is not the way the statute is indicating. So, this will be taken up as transfer only in the financial year 13-14 related to the relevant year 14-15. So, as far as assessment year is concerned, you have conveyed it very clearly. Then, what is the tax consequence? The cost of purchase, that being rupees 25 lakhs, will be taken up as nil. Now, I will show you the computation. Second part of the question. What is that? Sale value of the new property when sold by, what is the month? March 14. How much is that? 40 lakhs. Less cost of acquisition. How much is that? 25 lakhs. 25 lakhs in the inner column. So, exemption under section 54 is withdrawn. So, therefore, 25 lakhs minus 25 lakhs. Now, what is the cost of acquisition? Nil. So, short term capital gain. How much? 40 lakhs. The normal rate of taxation will prevail for this. Are you clear? That's it as far as this problem is concerned. Okay. Are you clear? Ah. But of course I told you assessment year 14-15 in which STCG will be offered for taxation. So this is conveyed in 54EC subsection 2 regarding the ineligibility of this gentleman, whereas this one is communicated in section 54(1) subsection A. So, you can just check up, that is what we have just read out. 54(1) subsection 1, sorry, 1(1). The cost shall be taken up as nil. Okay.